We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello friends, today we will see about the Ampere's circuital law. But before moving on the Ampere's circuital law is relates with what? So the answer is Ampere's circuital law is relate with the magnetostatics. In electrostatics, the Gauss law is useful to obtain the E bar in case of complex problems. Similarly, in magnetostatics, the complex problem can be solved using a law called Ampere's circuital law. The another name of Ampere's circuital law is Ampere's work law. Now the statement of Ampere's circuital law. So what is the statement of Ampere's circuital law? The Ampere's circuital law states that the line integral of magnetic field intensity H bar around a closed path is exactly equal to the direct current enclosed by that path. So, if we want to represent it mathematically, then what is the mathematical equation of Ampere's circuital law? Again, I am repeating the statement. What statement says that the line integral of magnetic field intensity H bar. So the line integral of magnetic field intensity H bar around a closed path. So this one is indicating the closed path is exactly equal to the direct current enclosed by that path. So it is I. So this one is the mathematical expression of Ampere's circuital law. Now we will see the proof of Ampere's circuital law. So before going to the proof, let us consider this figure. So, consider a long straight conductor carrying the current I. Placed along this Z axis. As shown in figure. Consider a closed circular path of radius R. Which encloses the straight conductor carrying direct current I. The point P, is at the perpendicular distance, R from the conductor. The next consideration is that consider this DL bar at point P, which is in the A phi direction, Now, this A phi is what? That is the normal to the point P. Okay, if we consider point P over here, then this one is the normal to the point P. But why it is phi only? Why there is no theta? Means that why we can write only A phi? Why not A theta? The answer is that इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द नॉर्मल ऑफ द पर्टिक्युलर एनी पॉइंट ऑन द सर्क्युलर पाथ, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द नॉर्मल ऑन एनी पॉइंट ऑफ सर्क्युलर पाथ, देन यू हैव टू फाइंड दैट नॉर्मल ऑन दैट पर्टिक्युलर पाथ ओनली. यू हैव टू फर्स्ट रीच दैट पॉइंट एंड आफ्टर दैट यू कैन फाइंड द नॉर्मल ऑफ दैट पॉइंट. सो वॉट इट मीन्स, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द नॉर्मल देन फर्स्ट यू हैव टू रीच दैट पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंट, देन एंड देन ओनली यू कैन फाइंड द नॉर्मल. सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ नॉर्मल ऑन ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ अ सर्क्युलर पाथ इज डिफरेंट. सो यू हैव टू मूव 360 डिग्री टू फाइंड द नॉर्मल ऑन ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट. दैट्स वाई यू हैव टू यूज फाई ओवर हियर, बिकॉज द फाई होल्ड्स द लिमिट ऑफ 0 टू 2 पाई. नाउ स्टार्टिंग विथ डी एल बार, स्टार्टिंग विथ डी एल बार, वॉट आई एक्सप्लेन अर्लियर, दैट इज द कंसिडर डी एल बार एट पॉइंट P, which is in the FI direction. So ultimately your DL bar is connected with what? Your point P. And your point P is connected with what? Your point P is connected with this R. Your point P is connected with this R and this FI. Your point P is connected with this R and this FI. But in this, your R is constant, because if you take R over here, the answer is same. If you take R over here, the answer is same. If you take R over here, the answer is same. But your FI changes with each and every point. So what you can write over here, is what? DL is connected with point P, and your point P is connected with what? Your point P is connected with R and FI. In that, your R is fixed, but FI is varies with respect to points. So it is FI DFI. Clear up to here? Okay. Now from Bio-Savart law, what you obtain the equation for H bar? From the Bio-Savart law, the equation of H bar is what? I upon 2 pi r into FI bar. This equation is from what? From Bio-Savart law. So therefore, what you want over here, you want H bar into DL bar. So what is the equation for H bar into DL bar? The equation is that is I upon 2 pi r FI bar into r FI bar over here, FI bar DFI. Okay, again FI is what? 1. FI is what? 1. This RR is to be cancelled. Therefore, H bar into DL bar is what? I upon 2 pi DFI. But what you have to do? You have to integrate this H bar into DL bar with respect to closed surface. So what over here? Integration of H bar into DL bar is equals to integration. Okay, what limit over here? You integrate with respect to phi. So limit is what? Phi. And what is the limit of phi? That is 0 to 2 pi. So it is I upon 2 pi d phi. But this I upon 2 pi is a constant. So I upon 2 pi, what over here? 1. That is integration phi is equals to 0 to 2 pi 1 d phi. So what is over here? I upon 2 pi, that is phi 0 to 2 pi. So what is this? Is equals to I upon 2 pi 2 pi minus 0. So here it is I upon 2 pi 2 pi. So this 2 pi is cancelled. So is equals to I. So finally you prove that is H bar into DL bar is equals to I. So this one is the Ampere-Circuiter law and the proof of the Ampere-Circuiter law. Okay, now what is the key point of this topic? Okay, the key point is that the path enclosing the direct current I need not be a circular and it may be any irregular shape. The load does not depend on the shape of the path, but the path must be enclosed. The path must be enclosed. So this one is the key point. Thank you.